Crystal Podcast. Dark to the side of the world of the dead.
Space, the only way to Okay, so I hope you survived that sort of triple whammy of extreme death metal, grindcore, metalcore there. First up, we had the wonderful Amputated. Great band. If you love like obscene lyrics and song titles, then you know they're the band for you. Some of their album titles include Wading Through Rancid Offal and Gargling on Infected Semen. So yeah, you know, fun for all the family there. So highly recommended, so check them out. After that, we had Burning Skies there with a track called War Hate from their Greed, Filth, Abuse, Corruption album, which came out in 2008. I think the band spend a lot of time split between Bristol and Berlin at the minute, but you can find them on MySpace and Facebook. So yeah, if you like the sound of that, check them out there. And to round off the extreme metal triple whammy there, we had Trigger the Bloodshed, who are, you know, they're formed in Bath, and they're based in Bristol and Bath. But they've done really well for themselves, like, you know, with their sort of style of extreme technical death metal music. They've been bigged up by Kerrang, Terrorizer magazine, and Metal Hammer mag as well. They're signed to Metal Blade Records, which is like, you know, world famous, and they've played Download Festival. They've toured with Meshuggah, Cannibal Corpse, and Dying Fetus. So that must have been a right old chuckle. But anyways, so basically that was Trigger the Bloodshed, and the track was called Sanctuary of the Wretched, taken from the 2009 album, The Great Depression. So again, if you like what you hear there, check them out, Facebook, MySpace, Twitter, blah, 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 Google it, YouTube it, you will find them, they are there. Okay, right, so it's sort of time now to sort of wrap things up a bit, but I mean, you know, this isn't the end, this is the beginning, because it's, you know, we've been looking at metal and hard rock and all that sort of stuff throughout the last sort of 30 years of Bristol musical history, but there's a hell of a lot more coming up. There's some great bands, a new generation of bands that are coming up. There's bands like, I'll give you a sort of reel some off, you know, there's Nasal Penetration, they do the sort of grind folky death metal stuff, definitely worth checking out. There's a band called Koshiro who are gigging all over the shop at the minute and working really hard. They do a sort of Deftones kind of groove metal sort of thing, so they're worth checking out. There's a band called Planting Claymore, they're very precise, kind of very influenced by Tool, and they use lots of strange time signatures and stuff. Dr. Nutt, they're an interesting band. They mix a classical music with sort of really old school kind of heavy metal riffs with a little bit of punk, and then a bit of, you know, it's all very tongue in cheek as well at the same time. And of course then there's bands like Garanga and Langa, that are sort of, they're not metal bands or hard rock bands as such, but they're very sort of grungy, and they've got like, they certainly have some killer riffs, so they're definitely worth checking out as well. And talking of killer riffs, it seems quite appropriate to kind of end the podcast with a band that specialises in absolutely killer riffs, and a band that, you know, if you had to say this band is going to be the big band from Bristol at the minute, you would just have to say Turbo Wolf. You know, I mean, these guys, they've been busting their balls for years now, and it looks like things are finally starting to pay off for them. And I spoke to Andy from the band, and he sent me some really nice information about what they're up to and what's going on. And their debut album is going to drop just before the summer. They're going to have like loads of festival stuff lined up. They've already played Sonosphere Festival, they've already played Download Festival, they've just come back off a European tour with Korn, of all people, Korn and Dimmu Borgir, so that must have been a pretty intense experience. There's lots of videos on their MySpace of, you know, little tour diary videos and stuff like that, which are well worth a look, you know. And yeah, I mean, they're doing really well. I know Metal Hammer, and the guys who do the Metal Hammer podcast are always big in Turbo Wolf up, Gill and Bees, and you know, they're in Kerrang, and they're just doing really, really well, so it's great. And I often see Andy, and I'm not sure the name of the singer, but the guy with the crazy moustache, but I often see him in the local spa down by the arches at Gloucester Road, picking up his beans or, you know, toilet roll or things like that, you know, so it's always quite funny. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to play a track from the EP, the Big Cut EP, which is free. You can actually get it. Andy's asked me to sort of say that you can actually get this EP, you can download it for free from their MySpace site, which is myspace.com/TurboWolfBand. So go there, check it out, get the EP, there's four tracks on it. Ancient Snakes on it, which is one of their sort of live favourites. So yeah, go and do that after you've listened to this. Thanks for listening to the show. It's been an absolute pleasure to do this, because I love metal, I love hard rock, I love noisy stuff, I love it, I love it, I love it. So please tune in next month for the next sort of regular podcast, where we'll be back to just playing the kind of the new upcoming bands. But yeah, here we go. This is Turbo Wolf and The Big Cut. We'll be right back.
Astral Podcast.